Families up and down the East Coast are bracing for yet another thrashing. More severe storms are now forecast to hit New South Wales and Queensland over the next few days.
To tell us just what to expect, we are joined by New South Wales SES Assistant Commissioner Paul Bailey, and Queensland's QFES Assistant Commissioner Tony Johnston. Let's go first to you, Paul. What is the latest on Cyclone Uesi?
Yeah, Uesi is impacting right now on Lord Howe Island. It's been quite devastating so far. We've had quite strong winds, reports of over 150 kilometres an hour. We're waiting to hear as that passes what sort of damage there will be. We've got crews on standby ready to go over to the island. We've also got an SES crew on the island to assist residents as that storm passes. So we'll see the damage as it occurs and help as we can.
Paul, my sister lives up towards the border of Queensland and New South Wales, and she said they've had a huge amount of rain. There's been localised flooding. There's been schools that have unfortunately been closed as well. Now we've got more rain heading in. What are the ramifications of that in the next couple of days?
Yeah, Carl, we did have a lot of rain over that area over the last 24 hours, certainly a lot overnight. 22 schools closed at this point in time, and we do expect some more. The rivers are moving quickly. We had them up to major flooding events overnight. It's quickly gone down to moderate at the moment. So we've got our crews out. We've got rescue teams out. We did another 20-odd rescues overnight in flood waters for people driving in. So we are urging people to really reconsider driving into any floodwaters.
Well, we know that many residents are still without power. You've now got this second storm surge coming. Do you have the resources to cope with yet another blow?
Yeah, we certainly do. We've got our teams ready. We're providing teams for Ausgrid at the moment. We've got another barrage of teams going out to Ausgrid to assist them to get that power back on as quickly as we can. We've called in extra crews to manage what we know will be coming over the next little while. We've bolstered our teams up in the Northern Rivers with some people from the Queensland SES and Queensland Fire Rescue. So we're doing as much as we can to prepare for what we know is coming.
OK, well, obviously, we wish you all the very best. Ausgrid's haven't had an absolute mare this past week, but hopefully they're on top of it as we head towards the weekend. Thank you for that. Let's go to QFES Assistant Commissioner Tony Johnston now in Queensland. Tony, good morning to you. Queensland has also experienced this torrential rain, as I've been talking about, and dangerous flooding over the past few days. How many calls for help have you been responding to, and what are you expecting?
Look, in the last 24 hours, we've had 503 calls from the community. Overnight, we had another 12 rescues from water. The crews have done fantastic jobs. We're encouraging people today, if you don't need to be on the road, to stay off the road. There's about 15 schools closed, so the weather for us abates a little bit today. There'll be some odd showers. We're also watching further north. Last night, as you know, Mackay area got a fair bit of rain. We're seeing a lot of thunderstorms come through where a lot of rain's just being dumped in a one-hour period, which caused some local flooding. We're just asking people to stay out of the flooded waters, not to go sightseeing, and allow the crews and councils to do the clean-up work so they can enjoy the countryside as soon as possible.
Tony, there has been and will continue to be the risk of flash flooding into the weekend. What are the areas of concern, and how long do you expect this to last?
Look, looking at the weather reports this morning, yes, there's going to be more thunderstorms, so we're just watching the hinterland, Mount Tambourine, the coastline itself. But we're also aware of the heat wave that's going to affect further parts of North Queensland itself, and we're making sure that we've got sufficient crews in those areas. I suppose at the moment for the southeast corner, we're just keeping a very vigilant look at the weather conditions, the rising water, because we've had a fair bit of rain in the backcountry, which will slowly come through as well.
OK, gentlemen, thank you so much for your time today. I know you've got a busy day. We wish all your personnel out and about all the very best. And could people please just stay out of the water? Don't try and go into any of those flooded roads. I mean, I don't know how many times they have to say it.